Levine too. They have more than 800 franchise business coaches in 22 countries. We're going to meet with business coach and franchisee to Action International, David Levine, coming up on Franchise Interviews on World Talk Radio. So stick around.
Sing a song for the broken hearted. Silent prayer for the departed.
Take control of your destiny and increase your quality of life with Allegra Print and Imaging. This light manufacturing, professional business-to-business franchise offers two unique opportunities to entrepreneurs with little or no industry experience. Our conversion opportunity is an existing business model that provides immediate cash flow, experienced staff, and an established customer base, while the low-investment digital print center opportunity meets the growing digital printing, sign, and mailing service demands of businesses in small and medium markets. Realize your dream of owning your own business with the comprehensive support of one of the world's top franchisers. Call 888-258-2730 or visit www.allegranetwork.com and discover the power in the network. Looking for the independence, freedom, and control of owning your own business? Invest in a winning opportunity. WSI is the world's leading white-collar franchise, ranked number one in its category by Entrepreneur Magazine for 6 years running. Right now, WSI is expanding its global franchise network in select high-growth markets. Do you have the motivation to run a successful and profitable business? Can you see yourself delivering highly effective internet marketing solutions to small and medium-sized companies in your local community? Find out now if your area is still available. Go to WSICorporate.com/radio to qualify now for your free multimedia franchise information package. Comprehensive training and certification, your own personal startup success coach, ongoing operations and marketing support. Whatever your business background, you can follow WSI's proven system to build a successful long-term business with multiple recurring revenue streams that will earn you money while you sleep. Qualify now for your free information package. Go to WSICorporate.com. That's WSICorporate.com/radio. Start living your dream today.
Listen. The world is talking. World Talk Radio.
Hi, everyone, and welcome back to Franchise Interviews, Asking the Entrepreneur Who Owns One. I'm your host, Marty McDermott, with my co-host, Don Johnson. And if you've ever dreamed about owning your own business, then this is a show to listen to. And today's show is being brought to you by WSI. And WSI has over 1,500 franchisees in 87 countries and is ranked the number one internet and technology services franchise in the world by Entrepreneur. Our next guest is David Levine, who is a business coach and franchisee for Action International. And David is very good at his job. He is very passionate about business. He is exceptional at finding solutions to problems. And I would say he's a motivational speaker. David, welcome to the show.
Thank you, Marty. Great to be here.
Thanks, David. David, on the line with us is also Don Johnson, which
Hello,
I think you
Don.
Know.
Yeah. Hi, David. How are you? Happy holidays.
Oh, same to you.
Yeah, you ready for us today?
I'm always ready for you.
All right.
David, in the beginning of the year, Don and I had a chance to attend one of your seminars at the Hyatt, and I think I told you this story, but 2 minutes after your seminar, I ran out into the lobby of the hotel, and I opened up my notebook, and I started writing the business plan for this radio show, which, you know, now thousands of people are listening to right now. So I wanted to thank you for that. You know, I think you were certainly one of the catalysts for getting this show going, and I think that's, I guess that's part of a business coach's job, right?
So first of all, you're very welcome, and it's a great flattering statement. And secondly, where's my cut?
There you go. We'll talk about that after the show, David.
No problem.
David, can you tell our listening audience where you're calling from today?
Calling from Central New Jersey, Middlesex County, to be more specific.
Okay.
In the eastern seaboard of the United States of America, on the Western Hemisphere.
All right, good. You guys are expecting snow today, aren't you?
I don't listen to the weather.
You don't listen to the weather.
It is what it is.
Much work
day, and we deal with it.
Absolutely. David, what were you doing before joining Action International? I know there's an interesting story behind it.
Well, I spent, I don't know if it's interesting, but I spent most of my career in corporate America, on the advertising agency side, working for accounts in New York City, and then working on client side in small, mid-sized, family-owned, as well as publicly held corporations in global positions in marketing and management. Became a dot-com casualty thrice over. And finally was training to do something completely different when someone says, come to a franchise seminar. And I said, a franchise seminar? I don't want to own a chain of nail salons.
Right.
And the guy dragged me along and met a guy from Franet, who you've mentioned a couple of times on the show,
right?
Where you get some of your data. Mm-hmm. And he said, come talk to me. It doesn't cost you anything. So as an entrepreneur kind of individual, just going to look for that, put a few things in front of me. And this thing of business coaching resonated with me. It was something that I do. It's the style of management that I've always applied in business, and it was a nice fit.
Right.
And that's how I became the second coach. We're now about, you talk about 800 around the globe. We're actually 900 in the globe.
Really?
In every continent except for Antarctica. The penguins are not really that interested right now.
That's incredible.
We are really moving along here. So I was coach number two in the state of New Jersey, taking a leap of faith there, and we're now over 30 in the state.
That's incredible.
That's great. It's a nice growth.
Thank you.
David, explain to people what a business coach is.
Well, that's an interesting question. First of all, the statistics we throw out, the phrase I like to use is, I don't tell you all of the wonderful things about Action International to impress you, but to impress on you that this stuff works. Business coaching does work. Your sponsor, WSI, in their pitch to get franchisees says, hey, we also provide a success coach, someone who's going to help you get to where you want to go. And that's what a business coach does. If I was to put it in a nutshell, it would be knowledge transfer. A consultant will borrow your watch to tell you what time it is, charge you for that information, and then walk away with your watch. A business coach will teach you how to read the watch. It's your business.
Interesting. And it's interesting, David, because, you know, you've heard a lot, you know, over the years of people now having, like, personal coaches and things like that, you know. So it was funny because I remember at one of your seminars when I was talking to you, you know, you were telling me that, you know, a lot of times you know more about what's going on in your client's life than their own spouse does.
Well, that's true, because when you look at it from a business point of view, your spouse wants to know that there's money in a checking account to spend it.
Certainly.
Your business colleagues that you meet at the club or in your networking events, you want to know, you want to present an image that everything's okay. And you never want to tell your employees that you're having some difficulties with an issue, because they look to you as the leader of the organization. Who else can you talk to that, A, is vested in your business because you're their client and want to see a success?
Right.
Number two, understand the business issues that you're dealing with. Try talking to someone who's not in business, who works for a large corporation in a position of power or not, and talk to them about payroll or cash flow. No, they know their marketing, they know their finance, they know their operations, but only you as a business owner are involved in all those areas.
Right.
A business coach understands that.
Yeah, recently, David, Marty and I both read the article in Franchise Times about the founder of Action International.
Yeah, Brad Sugars.
Brad Sugars. And that's a point that he really made, that business owners sometimes, where can they turn to? Sometimes you don't want to tell your wife, you're struggling, having problems,
mm-hmm.
Friends who maybe don't own a business, or like you said, you know, they're employees. So where do people turn to? It makes logic. They need someone to help them, a business coach.
Right, and that's part of the brilliance of Brad Sugars, in the sense that as a young man, he discovered he has a great ability of assimilating the knowledge base that's out there of people that are writing and speaking about certain areas within business, and combining all of that into one great system that is a best practices of how to make you successful at what you want to do. What are your goals? Your goals might be to have a business that works without you with a continuing income. Your goal might be to get out of the day-to-day routine and get out and see more clients. What is your goal for your business? Why did you go into business in the first place is the question you like to always ask. And what's your exit strategy, which is a question many people don't ask.
Right.
It's just like when you first met with Franette, some similar questions. What do you want to do? It's the same thing.
Correct.
As an Action International owner. What mostly intrigued you about Action International to get involved with them, David?
Well, for a personal point of view, although you may see me as very dynamic on the stage, I'm really a shy, introverted guy.
Oh, I never thought of you that way, David.
Are you being serious?
A little bit. From the point of view is that I like the corporate room. I like the support that a team provides to me. And everybody says, go out and hang out a shingle, become a consultant. You're really out there all by yourself. I think the phrase, and you're going to talk to Jerome Williams in a couple of weeks, a very good buddy of mine, a phrase he likes to use is, you're in business for yourself, but not by yourself when it comes to a franchise. And I thought that Action offered me the system that I didn't have to recreate the wheel, gave me access to other team players that we can consult with, my own coach, so to speak, and that allowed me to provide better value and service to my clients and a better story to my prospects.
It gave you a comfort level.
Absolutely.
Support, just like a true franchise system should.
And that's why I use that phrase. I like that phrase, which is you're in business for yourself, but not by yourself.
Right.
Certainly. Yeah. Could you describe the history of the organization, David? I mean, here Brad Sugar is a very, very young guy. Starts this very successful company.
Well, yeah, and it grew. Brad started his company in 1992 in Australia.
Mm-hmm.
And was assimilating a lot of business information and started giving seminars, feeling that, hey, this is a great way to make a living after doing a bunch of other things. And he would talk about the business systems that he was developing, and people would come up to him and say, can you help my business? And he saw, as you said earlier in the show, a niche to provide that service. And using the philosophy of leverage, doing more with less, you start to train the trainers and you get other people to buy into the system, because a franchise is a replicable system.
Right.
No matter what franchise it is.
Right, absolutely.
And he was able to build a network of business coaches, and through his leadership and growth and vision, he was able to franchise this from Australia to the Far East, which would be New Zealand and Asia, then Canada, the United States, Europe, and now, as we said earlier, 22 countries and every continent except Antarctica, with 900-plus and growing quite rapidly.
That's incredible. How would you describe the Action International franchise system, David, to somebody?
I would describe it as very different from any other franchise that's out there because we are entrepreneurs. So the franchise system has to be entrepreneurial as well. Therefore, there's an intranet for all us coaches to provide and have a dialogue. So if I have a question about a client of mine that I don't know, I can't answer, I can go on this forum and get an answer from someone in London or in New Zealand who has a client with the same issue. And if I've discovered and I've developed something with a client, a system that works, I can post that on our website, and all of a sudden all the coaches around the globe have access to it. So Brad's vision was, here's the system, now improve it, rather than most franchise, here's the system, don't change it.
Interesting.
So it's an entrepreneurial thing, and a lot of us are engaged and encouraged to be in other businesses. So we're business owners besides franchisees, which again provides more value to our clients.
Absolutely. It's interesting, David, because a lot of the research I've done on the other, Action International coaches, they said they have a lot more balance in their life, and I know you do a lot of other things as well. I know you teach for a college.
Yes, I'm
a university, actually.
At Rutgers University, yes.
Absolutely. And congratulations on the football team, by the way.
Hey, almost won.
Year. Almost.
Yeah, what a great year. That's my wife's alma mater. It's a great college.
Yes, yes. Very good school.
Okay. Tell people how big the business coaching industry is. Tell us a little bit about the industry in general.
Well, the industry in general, I'd rather talk about it from the point of view as the small and mid-sized businesses in this country.
Okay.
Everybody looks at the Fortune 500. Everybody talks about the Fortune 500, the Fortune 1000. Actually, that is a very small segment of GNP, Gross National Product. That's a very small segment of the employers in this country. The backbone of the United States is the small business owner. He provides, and I can't quote the statistics exactly, but he provides a majority of the employment, more than two-thirds of the employment of everybody in this country. He provides a tremendous contribution to the Gross National Product. we as business coaches go after the small and mid-sized company. Therefore, our industry as a place to play is tremendous. To give you some statistics, Don, was when I was examining the franchise and doing my due diligence, which I recommend to every franchise potential owner, is pulling up some SBA statistics, which said, like the Census Bureau said, in my county, Middlesex County, in 1999, there were 18,000 businesses under 99 employees.
Yeah.
I, as a business coach, can handle maybe 12 or 15. Do you think there's enough business for me in the county?
Yeah.
So we talk about abundance in Action International. There's tons of sharing. There's tons of abundance of opportunity out there.
I mean, that's a good point, because most of the whole U.S. business sector is the small, mid-sized businesses. You know, David, I'm involved with franchise and business financing. And,
right.
I mean, that's all who I finance, basically, the smaller size franchise and business loan. That's my main market. And
right.
Why Action International is successful. Those businesses are all over. There's new businesses starting up. You know, a lot of those people might not have the experience, and, you know, people need help. So
to your point exactly, I speak to a lot of bankers and a lot of people like that, and the business owner will come in and say, I need a loan. And the first question the banker is going to ask is, you got a business plan?
Certainly.
And they go, yeah, and they point to their head. It's all here. It's all in my head. I you know, it's not written down, but I know what I want to do.
Right.
And the same thing with you, Don. I mean, you want,
be successful. Right.
Yeah, you want to loan somebody money, but you want to see a plan. You want to know that they've thought it out. That whole process is something else that we help them with. So the allegiance between, or the strategic alliance between the banker, the small business banker, the franchise lending institutions like yourself, is a great thing, because we're going to help make sure that they're successful in order to pay back the loan. You're loaning money not because you're altruistic, but because you're making money on the VIG. Oh, I'm sorry, that's from New York. Not on the VIG, but on the on the interest that you charge. And as we all know, interest is merely a measurement of risk.
Right.
Right. You have to sell yourself. You got to be organized. Most loans get declined because people, well, the loans aren't packaged up right or complete, and mm-hmm. you know, people don't know how to put together a loan package or how to present themselves to a lender. So, yeah, that's a very valuable service.
What kind of businesses have they been, David? I mean, what are they? Who's a typical? Is there a typical client? You know, I mean, would it be a plumber? Would it be an electrician?
No, that's the beauty of business is. We talk in action speak of what we call BFOs, blinding flashes of the obvious.
Hmm.
I come from corporate America, so everything was multinational, multidimensional, matrixed management, very complex.
Right.
Learning the action system, business is extremely simple and the same. I don't care what business you are in, and everybody says, oh, my business is unique. Every business follows the same process. They all have the same five key areas: marketing, sales, finance, HR, and operations. I don't care if you're a law firm or whatever. You have all of these processes. You may not have separate divisions or departments, but you put on different hats at different times doing these different functions. And the process in which you acquire leads or prospects or suspects, get them to customers, have them buy again, make a profit, that whole process is the same no matter your business. So therefore, I have had clients that range from $5 million private investigation firms, to $2 million mechanic shops, to software development companies, to life insurance salespeople that are running their own little company, their own P&L department. So it ranges broadly across just about any sector.
Interesting.
Not to mention manufacturing or other service businesses.
Interesting. David and Don, we're going to take a quick break, and we're going to be right back. All right, with more franchise interviews on World Talk Radio, where the world comes to talk. Coming up in segment three, we're going to continue our interview with business coach and franchisee to Action International, David Levine, coming up on Franchise Interviews on World Talk Radio. So stick around. It happened too fast, you change your passion for the glory.
Don't lose your grip on dreams of the past. You gotta fight to keep them alive.
Take control of your destiny and increase your quality of life with Allegra Print and Imaging. This light manufacturing, professional business-to-business franchise offers two unique opportunities to entrepreneurs with little or no industry experience. Our conversion opportunity is an existing business model that provides immediate cash flow, experienced staff, and an established customer base, while the low-investment digital print center opportunity meets the growing digital printing, sign, and mailing service demands of businesses in small and medium markets. Realize your dream of owning your own business with the comprehensive support of one of the world's top franchisers. Call 888-258-2730 or visit www.allegranetwork.com and discover the power in the network.
You're listening to World Talk Radio, where the world comes to talk.
Hi, everyone, and welcome back to Franchise Interviews, Asking the Entrepreneur Who Owns One. I'm your host, Marty McDermott, with my co-host, Don Johnson. And if you've ever dreamed about owning your own business, then this is a show to listen to. And today's show is being brought to you by WSI, and WSI has over 1,500 franchisees in 87 countries and is ranked the number one internet and technology services franchise in the world by Entrepreneur. And today we are with David Levine, who is a business coach and franchisee to Action International. And Don, I think we left off with talking a little bit about the industry and.
David, I guess tell us what's been the most interesting thing that's happened to you since joining Action International.
Well, there's been a few interesting.
Probably have a few stories, right?
I think one of the things that's very interesting is that my desire of. Trying to figure out what's going on in someone else's head. What were their goals and objectives? You're almost playing a little bit of a business shrink to some degree, but people in their business are very tied together. I think the simplicity of business, the universality of it, is one of the interesting things. For me personally, trying to wrap my head on getting out of the international space and getting down to the local level was a challenge, but bringing all those experiences to bear has provided a great reward, and that I think is the most interesting thing. When you walk into a client's office and they go, David, I can't wait to tell you what happened this week.
Wow, right.
Really, that makes you feel so good that the message is getting through.
Right.
Or when I start with a client and my first question is, because they think they've hired me because of, let's say, my marketing background, and I come in and I say, all right, let me see an aging report, a balance sheet, and a P&L statement, and the two answers I usually get are, huh? Or my accountant handles
right.
all of that, and then teach them how to read their financial statements, that all of a sudden I come back 6 months later or, after doing this every week for them for the next 6 months and then showing them different things, and all of a sudden they go, David, look what I just learned how to do in QuickBooks. This is a great report.
Right.
So
that's
just really
fabulous.
Your high is just really seeing somebody develop and grow and become successful. That's interesting. I guess part of your job is adjusting to people's personality. Everybody's different, so you have to quickly find out how people are, and then I guess once you're really making a difference in that business, I guess that's a nice feeling.
It's a wonderful feeling.
Do you find they become very dependent on you at times too, David? Certain clients?
Some do. I've gotten calls. I'm out in the evening, get a call. I'm just about to walk into a sales meeting. What do I say? And this is a woman that's built up a $10 million sales business. So it's funny that sometimes they do become a crutch, but your job is to show them how they can do that themselves. And that's something you also teach where a perfect example is that employees become dependent on their bosses.
Certainly.
And business owners and franchises or in small businesses are constantly being interrupted. What should I do now? And the boss says, all right, do this, this, and this. And I turn around and said, you know what you've just done is you've just taught him that anytime he needs to make a decision, he's got to come back to you.
Right.
As opposed to saying, what do you think you should do? That's a great idea. Go do it. And he won't come back and bother you again because he knows that's what you want him to do.
Interesting. That's something. What type of characteristics, David, make for a successful Action International franchisee?
Well, I think you said it when talking about me before about passion. I mean, you really have to have a passion for business. My wife makes a joke that most husbands have a garage full of hobbies or a basement with a workbench. My hobby is business. I live for business. That's what I basically do. So I think it's a passion for that. It's being able to sell yourself, because even though we have a great system, the client is buying you. The client is not buying Action International.
Right.
Action International is there for us to help the business owner, but the business owner is relying on you.
Certainly.
That's a good point, yeah.
Yeah, and that comes across in your seminars too, David. You know, when we were there, you know, the passion that you have for business, you know, you can see that.
Thank you.
All the top business people say that. You have to love what you do. That's going to come through in dealing with people, clients, and being successful. So it's kind of when you initially were looking at Action, you wanted to figure out what you wanted to do. I think that's so key initially. You know, you want to be, are you more in office person? You want to get out and meet people? You have to kind of figure out what you like doing best, and that's probably going to lead to you being happy in business overall.
Well, absolutely. If you're not a morning person, don't buy a Panera Bread or an Atlantic
right.
Bread franchise, because you got to get up in the morning and make the bread. You know, you got to balance that out to yourself. But you touched upon, and one thing leads to another. We talk about what you like to do. If you, one of the biggest, three biggest areas with entrepreneurs or business owners is time, team, and money. And in the area of money, I'll leave that to you, Don. In the area of time, it's that they're always busy doing things they may not want to do. So they have to manage their time so that they can leverage out of what they don't want to do and spend their time doing what they want to do, which is why they went into business in the first place.
Right. What's the training like, David, when you became an Action International franchisee? What did you have to go through? What's the process like?
Besides military boot camp?
Yes.
No. the training is twofold. It's intense and it's ongoing.
Okay.
It's a 10-plus day training in our U.S. headquarters, which is in Las Vegas, Nevada. And then what we do ongoing is that every coach that comes out of training has 12 or more weeks of weekly phone calls with other new coaches and a coach's coach. There are quarterly team meetings. There are annual national meetings. And the structure with your master franchisor of your state might have weekly calls. There's the forum. There's a lot of support going on. So we're constantly learning. I at least have the philosophy is once you stop learning, you die.
Mm-hmm. Certainly, I would agree with that.
Okay, yeah.
But one point is that, if I may interrupt, is that you don't become a good business coach if I graduate college with my MBA or my BS degree in something and I say, let me buy a franchise. You're really going to be successful as an Action business coach after having a number of years of business experience,
right.
Real world experience that you can bring to the table.
Certainly.
And I guess really training is never going to stop even for...
Correct. So if you look at my picture on my website, you'll see a lot of gray hair.
Okay. Explain and I guess from speaking so far, there's probably not a typical day for an Action International franchisee, but can you maybe talk about what, you know, some of the things people do on a daily basis?
Well, that's a good question. The typical day is you're spending time meeting with prospects because you're always trying to keep, as a salesperson, part of your process is to build your funnel and to build your business, and therefore we have that sales techniques. We go through all that sales training, which is something else we bring to our clients. We teach and we preach what we learn. We meet with prospects, we are networking, we're speaking, we're solving problems. I mean, just because we meet with a client between that hour or 2 hours or every other week period of time doesn't mean that we're not working on that client's problem as we move forward.
Right.
So therefore, we're consulting with others, we're reviewing documents that they've sent us as part of their homework, and that's a lot of fun, is assigning a grown-up business homework. And that's something that occurs to us. And we're always, as you've pointed out, I mean, we do speaking. We go to networking groups. We're leaders in our networking groups, our local B&I chapters and the like, our chambers. So we're always out there and giving back to the community. For example, I belong to the Main Street Society of my town, revitalizing the Main Street.
Mm-hmm.
I know a lot of our coaches are involved in local theater groups or local businesses, always doing something back for the community, local community organizations.
That's interesting.
Right, and you mentioned sales. Is it really a criteria for a new Action franchisee to have that past sales experience? I imagine it's taught during training and everything. But
let's say it's not the experience, but at least the attitude to go out there and sell yourself. I mean, it's very hard for people to do that. People don't like to boast about themselves. People, I think when we teach selling, the hardest thing that people do, they do all this great stuff, and they forget to ask for the sale.
Right.
So sales experience is helpful. However, sales is a skill that can be taught.
It's a good point. I teach my staff here. You got to eventually ask. Are you moving forward with us or not? You're right about that point. David, what advice would you give to aspiring entrepreneurs looking to buy a franchise? This is a question we like to speak to people about. A lot of people listening, want to hear about this type of information.
That's a tough question. It's a simple question, yet it's a very tough one. You've got to find something that matches to you. I mean, from my own personal experience, I did not want to do retail. Some people love retail. I did not want to do retail.
Right.
Some people had service. Somebody had presented to me one of the handyman franchises. But managing people to do things that I don't do is not something that I'm comfortable with.
Right.
Motivating people, helping them make decisions, managing them in a similar way that was part of my personality, the coaching aspect, that worked for me. It resonated. So the first thing I would look for an aspiring entrepreneur or franchise owner, whether you're going to go out on your own or buy a franchise, is find something that matches your avocation or your vocation, because you want to really make it happen. The other thing is to do the plan. Really go through that due diligence of what some people call the UFOC, or the Uniform Filing Offering Circular.
Mm-hmm.
Go through that. Do your due diligence and talk to people that have been in the system a few years, or even just out of training in their system, and those that have been in it for a while. You're going to find a normal bell curve, and you want to talk to the successful ones, but don't forget to talk to the average and those that have not done well, and find out, learn from their issues why they haven't done well, and say, I won't make that mistake, and I really want to do this, and I'll follow the lead. And the last thing is seek advice. Just because you're a small business owner doesn't mean you can't have a board of directors like large corporations have.
Sure.
That board of advisors, and I'll call them advisors rather than directors, because if I do share responsibilities of directors versus advisors, accountant, banker, lawyer, and, of course, the business coach. You've got to have people that you can talk to and say, hey, I was presented with this. What do you think about that? Guys, I've got this issue. What do you think we should do about this?
Right, to get as many opinions, and I think the most important thing you said was, the due diligence aspect. We see a lot of people just jump into a franchise. It's a big name. And, hey, of course, I'm going to be successful. But, hey, you got to look at all the bad and good and do your homework and not jump into it and get outside advice, everything you're mentioning, David. So
but, Don, I want to jump on one thing you said, and that was get a lot of opinions. I want you to get a lot of opinions, but you need to make the final decision. It's like Captain Kirk sitting at the table with all his different department heads. Everybody voices their opinion, but it's his decision on where the ship goes and what mission they take on. Take opinions, but remember, it's your decision and your responsibility, so you've got to balance that out. Just don't do what everybody else tells you to do.
Right. Also a good point, yeah.
David and Don, we're going to wrap things up, but David, I wanted to thank you. You were a fabulous guest, and I look forward to attending one of your next seminars.
Well, it's very easy to do. Just go to my website, which I know you'll have a link on yours. We'll put up the schedule under events for 2007.
Absolutely. We have a link under on the show page. It's ABI Coaching, isn't it, David?
Yes, it's abicoaching.com. And for those people that are listening in other parts of the country or even other parts of the world, I suggest they go to actionmembers.com.
Okay.
And be able to find a listing there of every coach in the globe and their web pages, and be able to see those people as well.
Ah, great.
And
we could post that up
in
the show page
area
as well, David.
Jersey, we definitely want to see you and talk to you.
Absolutely. Thanks again, David. It's been a pleasure speaking with you again.
All right. I look forward to it.
Okay. Thanks. Take care, David.
Take care. Thanks very much, Don and Marty.
Okay. Thanks, David. Nice job, Don.
Yeah, thank you, Marty.
All right. And I guess we'll see each other next week, right? We're going to have another great guest, and it's going to be a lot of fun.
Yeah, another good show. That was great.
We'll
get some shopping done, Marty.
Absolutely. I'll talk to you next week, Don.
Okay.
Take care. Bye-bye.